Hey everyone, Gabriel Nassif for ChannelFireball.com, and today I'm going to be playing some Modern. I know that at first glance it might not look like Modern, it might look like Pioneer almost, but it's a deck I built yesterday. I played it one league on my stream, and it went kind of okay. I got more wins than losses, got a bunch of 2-0s and a couple 0-2s, but deck was alright. The idea was to try to abuse the great hand in Modern and maybe try to overwhelm a lot of decks that are playing 1-for-1 removal was the great hand in company. You also get extra mana guys in Modern. You get the Hierarchs on top of the 8 elves. You could also play Arbor Elves, but that would require you to play pretty much all basic forests, and I have some fetch lands, I have a Pendle Haven, and I have the Canopy lands. So yeah, it's pretty much a great hench deck, almost you know, not exactly standard, but it's a bunch of mana guys. You're trying to play you know, a 5-power creature on turn 2 and then cast either company or great hench the following turn, kill your opponent fast. I think you're gonna have decent game against mid-range decks. I beat a Jun deck and a Blue Moon deck yesterday, as well as E-tron, which kind of makes sense to me. Kind of free control mid-range decks that don't kill you super fast, that are not super unfair. And then I actually lost to two Skyclave Apparition decks. I lost to an Aether Vial kind of Eternal Witness deck with Uro and Omnath, mid-range creature decks that seems pretty good against other creature decks. And even then I didn't get the henchin to play either games. And I think that in both games, if I get the great henchin play, I'd probably win. And then I lost to Spirits, Ban Spirits, another Skyclave Apparition deck. And it was like really close games. So I'm kind of hopeful. I'm sure we're gonna maybe hit a blind spot during the league. Some maybe, you know, maybe a Titan deck that ramps a bit too fast, or maybe a combo deck that doesn't care about cards like Revoker and Ooze. But I figured I'd do something a little different. I've been trying to find, you know, kind of different decks in Modern when I play. I don't play a ton of Modern, but kind of trying to have a bit of fun with it rather than play the best decks. And, you know, also somewhat of a budget options. Big change since yesterday is that I added some Canopy lands. I didn't pair it against any red decks, so we'll see if I ever get punished for that, but I added 3 Canopy lands. Yesterday I was just playing 15 Forests, 1 Pendle Haven, and 4 Fetch Lands. And I added a Fetch Lands and 3 Canopy Lands. The Fetch Lands are just to thin the deck and 4 Maras, but it did come up a decent bit yesterday. And I definitely felt like I wish I had more Fetch Lands in the deck. You also want to be careful not start losing to, you know, a Blood Moon draw, etc. People have also started playing Blood Sun in Modern, which is the cantrip red into enchantment that doesn't let you sack fetch lands. So gotta be a bit careful, but yeah. Bunch of elves, ooze, revoker as kind of hate cards. It's also cool that it's a 2-mana creature that you can cast right away off henge. And the companies, and then the sideboard is kind of what you would expect. A Rex Sage, couple chokes, a Gaia's Blessing, an oof, some one-offs creature, you know, extra Revoker, extra Ooze. I had Solgad Lantern in my sideboard yesterday. I decided to cut them. I just don't feel like there's that many matchups where I'm going to be excited to bring in Solgad Lantern over Ooze. I had 3 or 4 Veils yesterday, but the way your deck plays out, Veil can be a bit awkward, so maybe you don't want to overdo it. So I just went a couple, and instead I'm trying a Shaper Sanctuary that you can just run out there and not have to keep mana up the whole time. And, you know, maybe against a deck like Junt, even them just minusing a run in 6 on one of your elves, you know, is going to get you a card. So that card can be strong. Obviously, they can use a Broad DK on it, but I'll try that. Not a Revoker. I'm not super sold on the Revoker. I'm pretty sold on the Ooze, but I'm not sure. Revoker was kind of okay against me for me yesterday. It forced them to use a apparition on them when I had them on violin. And I'm going to play a tracker, which I didn't have yesterday. Gaia's Blessing is for the mail decks. There's been a bunch of mail decks. You can play either Gaia's Blessing if you're playing green. If you're not playing green, you can play a Kozilek. one of the Eldrazi that reshuffles. The downside of Blessing over Kozlek in my deck is that, or in most decks, is that you can't discard it to hand size. If you have Blessing in, you know, you draw, you keep your seven, your first draw step is a Blessing, and you don't have, you know, you can't discard it to hand size and reshuffle at some point. So, but overall, I think Blessing's probably a bit better than having Kozlek when you can cast it. And yeah, four Kitchen Finks. I didn't play against red decks yesterday. I'm hoping that'll be enough. Assuming Big Green Monsters was great hand genus should be okay against red, but it's popular deck and you can use the help. So yeah, I think this is it for the deck. So I guess I'll just jump into a league.
The Ultimate Magic Gift Box is the perfect gift for a friend this holiday or for you to treat yourself. With insane value in every box, you won't want to miss out. Get yours today at channelfireball.com.
I was debating playing this deck. I also had another deck I tried out that was not super strong for me, though. It was... where is it? It was basically the Irayo deck I was playing the other day, except it has JVP, Jace Vintage Prodigy, instead of Irayo. And it relies more on the one mana discard spells. I played a league with it. I did have a winning Rykard, but it felt like highway robbery. I felt like I got pretty lucky to get a lot of my wins. And I think this deck might be okay if you play all eight discard spells. It always felt pretty bad when I didn't have a discard spell on turn one. I was only playing six. So I think if I played the deck again, I would just play all eight discard spells. All right, pretty solid hand. That's what you're looking for. Turn on elf, turn three, free drop. Few thoughts on that deck. Oh yeah, Turntable or Symbiosis. That's a new Mythic Split land card. That card might be okay. I could see it being better than maybe Waterlogged Grove. Because in grindy games, you do get to like seven mana, I think. A decent bit with all your elves and stuff. And you find some nice targets, you know, 7/6 Steel Leaf Champion can be good, or finding Uronus could be good. Upside of Waterlogged Grove is that it sacks a bit earlier in the game. And yeah. I see the number of elves is kind of debatable too. I'm playing 12. Feels about right. You can maybe trim some in some sideboard games. Maybe if you're on a draw against a Renin 6 deck. Could see trimming that. Marsh Flats. Could be Death and Taxes. And I guess they don't play Marsh Flats. Death Shadow. Death Shadow, kill your elf. No problem. I got another one. You could maybe cut elves for a land or two extra. All right, I'm going to mess around, I guess. Drew my land, just going to put hopefully a couple of creatures in play. Ooh, double rowing us. All right. Not that bad. That's a lot of great edge to bottom of the deck, though. All right, looks like our opponent's stuck on lands. Mulligan into the one lander. Playing Lurrus. I didn't even notice Lurrus when I kept my hand. I'm pretty bad at that, you know. Especially if you're playing a reactive deck, make sure you check for the companion zone, for sure. Play Steel Leaf so I can attack with Ronas. And don't want to sag the land. I'll just getting for max damage and keep my lands to be able to use Ronas' ability. All right, not the most competitive game here. Bringing that Shaper Sanctuary, coupled Veil. So they're probably playing red black shadow. Red black shadow. Revoker seems pretty bad. It's an easy cut. Red black shadow, depth shadow, swift spear. Loris. Ooze hits Loris to have a bunch of creatures. Can get pretty big in the mid game. I could bring in Tracker for value. I'm a bit scared the game's gonna be over faster though when they have a good draw. I don't know about Kitchen Finks. Bizey's Diamond, it's a pretty good combo with Henge, Infinite Finks. It's also a decent hit of company if I need a chump, because sometimes they might just have a huge shadow and all I want is a chump blocker. Do I want to cut an elf or two on the draw if I'm bringing Valen? I don't think so. I don't think you want to cut elves. I don't think you ever cut Mammoth. That card's really good for me in the league yesterday. I played it all in a few times. Just the body was good. Yeah, it's tough. I can maybe trim a Great Henge just because it's going to be harder to stick against all their removal and discard spells. Maybe trim an elf. Yeah, that's okay. Good to see Fings being a bit better than Steelleaf Champion as well. Maybe I'll try that. I haven't boarded out Steelleaf Champion in my league yesterday, but against that deck, it kind of makes sense. Targeted themselves, I'm assuming. The elf can be useful for a Lovestruck Beast. I think elf is probably still a bit worse overall. I'm assuming it's gonna die. So I'm gonna play elf on turn one. Yeah. Scary stuff. Huh. All right, definitely playing that. Oh, kind of tricky. I kind of want to play a Mammoth here, I think. I guess that's another reason to bring in Kitchen Finks. It's good against Court of the Skyclave. Yeah, because if they don't have a burn spell here or haste creature, Kitchen Finks could just get there. Oh no. Jig is up. Bye bye, Kitchen Finks. Come on. Oof, I'd add bolt anyways. Okay. I was in trouble. 8-8. Yikes. Already in chum block mode. All right, let's see. Heart's Desire. I'm Need a bunch of Chumblock. I have a Chumblocker, I guess. I guess I'll cast a Mammoth. I should have cast a Lovestruck Beast, actually, just to be able to cast a Great Henge and yeah, have a better blocker against Death Shadow and be able to cast a Great Henge, I guess, is two reasons. Should I just take the hit down to two? I don't think so. Interesting. All right. I was gonna say go and hope to hit Ronas would be pretty incredible here. Death Touch. Ronas. I guess it can't block if I don't have four power creature. Bunch of kitchen things would be good. Doesn't even do it anymore, right? Another Death Shadow is not lethal. Not even close. Let's see. I could double block. And then if I draw fetch land, I have 9 damage potentially, actually. I'm just gonna get the beefy ones. It's kind of close. I have potentially lethal with a mammoth. But I think they have a spell as their last, and I guess it could be a land. I guess I'm dead. They have lightning bolt. Yeah. Team of Battle Rage. Alright. Alright. So yeah, tracker, don't we have time for it? The Great Henge, I'm a bit worried I'm gonna be stuck with the Henge in hand. Do I want Ooze or Elf? I think this looks pretty decent. Still, yeah. All right, I'll keep. Not the flashiest hand, but could have definitely played that turn on. If they have Inquisition, they could take it. All right. All right, so they have a removal for a Lovestruck Beast, or they have another discard spell. I think even though they have Death Shadow in their deck, you just want to attack them. Guess Love's Rugby's first. Maybe they use their removal on that. Fatal Push. Okay. Okay. Picking my hand apart, I see. Maybe Shaper Sanctuary is just nuts. Yeah. That's why I wanted to board out one hinge. I figured that that scenario might come up. Now they play Lurus. I think I should maybe, it's close. What do they have in their graveyard? They have Bubble. This game's probably over. See if, given how this game is playing out, I wish that side worded differently. I guess I wish that Hench was just a creature. Hench is pretty tempting though. Also, you could argue that you want to trim some else because the game's going to go a bit long, but I have these canopy lands. I only have like 17 lands really. Do I want to play an elf? Do I even want to play my land? I have the Mammoth in my deck. Of Company. What could I draw? All right. Looks like we fell a bit short. It's kind of a tough matchup. They have all their one mana interaction. It's pretty decent. And they drew their cards in the right order. They drew like all the discard spells. Yeah, that's one reason to play the Elf Inquisition. Yeah. Now they're drawing two cards a turn. I need a Company. It's not just play the elf. Should have maybe just stayed back. I can still win. Company into Ronas. Maybe attacking was bad. Now they can start playing Shades. Should have just stayed back and double block Lurus. And if they want to use a removal on one of my 1/1s, I guess that's fine. What do they have? They're not even sacking Canyon or anything. Should I keep attacking? Well, they don't have Shade in hand. They're going to draw one at some point. Maybe I should have been playing my land. I have 4, 5, 6, 7. Oh, I could have cast Great Henge actually this turn. I didn't think about that. Maybe not. I guess I have a removal for Hierarch. Yeah, smart. All right, I'm just going to say go and try to double block Lurus. Yeah, Shaper Sanctuary would be the nuts in this matchup. They just Can almost never beat it. They've played, what, 1, 2 free removal spells already? I have 6 cards in hand. Like Tear of Battle Rage in hand. Yeah, maybe you just board out all the elves. And a forest them to use a removal spell on a 1/1. I guess it was really good against them too, just getting rid of Bubble for Lurrus because the games are going to degenerate. And yeah, I guess I should have brought in more value cards. I like underestimated their ability to get to the mid game. I think I should have 4 Ooze in my deck. I think I should have the Tracker. Yeah, I'm not sure I should even have all the Steel Leaf champs, but I think Ooze and Tracker at least. If I just had Ooze for their bubble, I probably would be perfectly fine. It's also possible I wanted to play Ooze on turn 3 and just get the bubble right away. Huh. So late. Bit late. That lethal should be, it's 12. All right. Well, I could say it was kind of close, but we only won the game where they didn't play a second land. They draw pretty well in these other games, but their deck just draws well. I mean, that red black deck's pretty consistent. Yeah. I think I sideboarded maybe slightly off. And, you know, also just seeing which sideboard cards are pretty impactful and which are not might be important for this deck. I think that's, you know, you get access to some good sideboard cards for your deck in Modern, even though you don't have all the tools you wish you had. For this matchup specifically, Shaper Sanctuary seems nuts, and maybe more Veils too. I'm on the draw, and I don't know. I have a 1-mana guy, but I do have 1-drop, 2-drop, 3-drop Henge, so I guess I'll keep. Right. Probably Uro control, Sultai Uro control. Let's see how this matchup goes. I think I'll save the Ooze for now. I'll use my fetch land. Better against Reman too. I think these matchups are going to be close but tough. I hope close. Uros can be kind of a problem, and Field of the Dead's kind of a problem in the late game too. Especially if they're playing a version with Hour of Promise. If they're playing Growth Spiral, they probably have Hour of Promise. Opponents in the tank, what could it be thinking about? Which land to play? Whether to slam a Jace or not? Like if they had a Jace, they would slam it. Maybe they have Narset in hand? Okay, yeah. Keep counter mana up or play an Uro maybe. Okay, that's fair. I think these lists I've seen was 28 lands. I think they should have made maybe more lands, maybe like 29 or 30, and maybe play Fjord Mystic Sanctuary, Ronas, Lovestruck Beast. Let's see. Definitely not Ronas. I guess just almost definitely Lovestruck Beast, maybe Steelleaf Champ. The list I've seen play zero sweepers, zero or one sweeper. You could argue Steelleaf Champ just because it attacks past Peel of the Alakid? What? Oh, they're playing Dryad in their deck. Huh. Okay. Did not expect to see a Alakid. Whenever they're playing Titan. Okay. Interesting. Something's going to be tough. All right, I need to get rid of Uro. All right, step one. I'll keep a mana up for now, I guess. So they can't just Mystic Sanctuary back Hour of Promise on top. Actually, I should have maybe done it on my turn while they're all tapped out. Oof. All right, I'm gonna get to kill my ooze too. Rough. Be pretty hard to keep up. I mean, it does gonna put Hour of Promise back on top, right? If I'll try and remove it. I'm just costing myself one life. Yeah, a small mistake by me. Well, potentially big mistake by me, I guess. I'm not removing that Hour of Promise right away. I'm pretty likely to lose this game anyways, but... Alright, I think I'm dead. Alright, I had a bit of a slow start. I was on the draw. That pretty solid hand too. I think we can do something on the play here. Dryad. Let's see. Where's my Rex Sage? Bye bye Revoker. Bringing Ooze number 4, bringing Tracker. Veils, I mean, we didn't see that much. They mostly just ramping. Shaper Sanctuary could be okay, maybe. What should I trim? Just trim Steel Leaf Champ, not a tech's best name. Maybe just trim Lustrug Beast. Down 4 Ooze. I really want to be able to get rid of Uro and have cards for Mystic Sanctuary. Maybe it is Lustrug Beast. Maybe I don't want Reclamation Sage just because I have Choke anyways. So the 2/4 is not great for them. Yeah, screw Reclamation Sage. I'll do 4 Lovestruck Beasts. 3 years will be good enough. All right, just a couple Chokes for whatever, and 2 Choke and a Tracker for bunch of Revokers. I think I like my chances on the play. They're probably pretty light on interaction. Thing I have to keep, but I'll see. Yeah, I was a bit worried about these decks. I figured maybe between the Henge and Steel Leaf Champ, I could get them a bit low and finish them off with some Steel Leaf Champs against their army of zombies, or just kind of go off with the Great Henge. Of course, if you like the video, make sure you subscribe to the channel. That always helps. You can also check out the cards we're selling at channelfireball.com if you want to build this deck or another deck, you know, that helps support the, if you like the content, that's a good way to support it. You can support me directly when you shop there and use code YellowHat. That, you know, gives me a little commission. And right now, if you use my code YellowHat, you also get a token, one of my tokens. I'll show you in a second there. They're pretty sweet. Let's see. Let's play Horizon Canopy. Can't speak English. Like that. Let's play Steel Leaf Champ. And let's play a an elf, right? Might as well. I guess elf is better with Great Henge. Maybe I should have played Heart's Desire. But yeah, obviously this video is brought to you by ChannelFireball. So if you ever need singles, if you need box product, right now for Christmas they have an ultimate gift box. I think a lot of them sold out, but they have a few left. All that good stuff. All right, let's see. It's not just attack as a mammoth alone. Same amount of damage. And then I can decide. Lead was that. And figure out if I need to play Love Struck Beast as a 5/5 or just play a 1/1 and sack Canopy. I think I'm just going to play. We could have Damnation. It's not impossible. How much damage? 8. I don't think adding that 1/1 fundamentally changes anything. I'll just say go. It looks more like Cryptic Command Zone here. Never a bad thing to have them in the Cryptic Command lock early. Question is, you play Company? I think you do. Case they untap an Hour of Promise. I think that's more likely to happen than them having a sweeper, etc. I could have also just cast Heart's Desire off an elf pre-combat. I guess that's another reason to do it. You find the news. So they call me Six Sanctuary easily, etc. Little menus too, for those of you who don't follow the competitive scene super closely. I got I think my third top 8 in a row in a major event this year. I top 8ed the Zendikar Rising Championship that was split standard and historic on Arena. So that's pretty happy. Unfortunately on Sunday I just wheels kind of fell off. I lost my two matches right away, double elimination bracket, so I came in 8 or 7/8, you know. But it was a great run. I got some precious points for the Magic Pro League season. And different formats, but yeah, standard is sorry. That's usually what I play on my stream. If you want to see more of me too, like I stream pretty much every day on Twitch, twitch.tv/yellowhat. And usually playing some Arena. I'm playing a bit more modern now because we have kind of a break. Our next big event is not for another months over a month, so it will be historic again though. All right, so this is 5 points guaranteed. Then they block the two biggest one, and I'm actually I'm 0 points short, right? Block mammoth, block a news, take 6, 7, 8, 9. All right. Every point of damage matters. I think I might still win if they get an untap step, because at least I have ooze, so it's kind of hard for them to log, but close. Damn. I respect. Hoping I don't see the onboard kill. So they do have Mana Leak in their deck, maybe then Reman and stuff. I still don't know if I want Veil. Veil doesn't do, I mean, they're going to use Cryptic to tap my creatures almost always. So that's not going to do much. Ooze does seem really, really important. Even though drawing multiple feels bad. Their deck can maybe flood a bit and not do much once you can remove their graveyard. It's kind of close. All right, I think I'll trim. Maybe Tracker is too slow, too little, too slow. They don't have that much interaction. I just won't do Tracker. No, it seems like I might be making the same mistake that I did against the red black deck, but they operate differently. They take over in different ways and not sure the extra card. There's like, at some point, there's like nothing I can really draw into, you know, anymore. Whereas the red black deck, I can always probably draw into stuff, relevant cards. All right, I mean, I'd love to see a choke in my opening hand. But this left to do. Pretty solid hand overall, I guess. They might have an awkward mana draw. If they're leading with Breeding Pool, if they're not leading with Fetchland for Triumph or... They paused a bit before keeping. Or maybe not, maybe they just have Z-Nuts. All right, I'll just play my best creature right away. Yeah. That's six right on me. All right, can I have my Reclamation Sage back? We need a land here. We need a land badly. If I draw a land, maybe I have a shot. All right, no respect. My bad. No respect for the Dryad. No Reclamation Sage. I feel like the turn you take off playing a Reclamation Sage, you know, is just so underwhelming. This is nice, though. Dryad Mystic Sanctuary. I haven't seen actually... I'm not even sure I've ever seen these two cards in the same deck, really. It makes a ton of sense. It fixes your mana, too. Like it. Wow. No on tap. Oh no, never mind. My Steel Leaf is, that was actually one of the reasons to play Hierarch over. Not that you really have another elf, but you get to do that at least. All right. Still get to cast a great henge. And question is, do you play elf or do you play ooze? Could play ooze and hope to draw a land. But if I don't draw a land, it's just going to die to a bolt. I guess it's just going to die to a bolt anyway, so. All right, can the Great Henge overpower all of that? I doubt it, but you never know. The Great Henge is a pretty messed up card. And I do have Choke in my deck. I can see just having four Choke in my sideboards. It's not great in every blue matchup that I like. Brought it in against Ban Spirits yesterday and it actually cost me the match. It was kind of close. I brought in like, I think I had three in my sideboard and maybe I brought in two. And I ended up losing to a draw that was a single Plains and two Aether Vial. And I had Choke in hand while I had boarded out all my Phyrexian Revokers. I brought in Collector Oath for Vial, but I didn't keep in the Revokers and... But in this matchup, seems like Choke's soul is going to be good. I mean, they're playing freaking Mystic Sanctuary. All right, Ghost Corridor. Could be worse. Could definitely be worse. Fetch Land. That's bad. Yeah, as long as they don't have a card advantage engine, I guess they have a Boro every turn. They can play a Boro twice a turn. Yeah, I really need to find that Choke. Not even sure Choke does it. They still get to play a Boro twice a turn, even with Choke. Wow. This is gonna be tough. Let's see. Next turn at six mana. Probably we'd lead with company and then play an ooze. Oh no, they're gonna kill my heart too. You heard it, food's here. All right. I think I should still probably go with company first. Oh. Choke straight to the bottom. Yeah, can I still win? I'm honestly not sure I can still win, but we'll see. We'll try. I think step one is drawing a choke. Step one is them not having anything good. Step two is me drawing a choke, and then I think I can be just two bolts a turn, maybe. All right, looks like that Hour of Promise. Oh, tight. Do they have a second Valakut? I haven't really seen take on their deck, or maybe it's like most recent take on the deck. All right, even if they don't have a second Valakut, I don't think I can win. And they do. All right, rough start. Bit of a rough start. Definitely feels like the deck's really Dyrrell dependent. Anyways, you know what always cheers me up? Giving our awesome sponsor Ultimate Guard a shout out. They have an amazing product. That's another great way you can support this content. Or just, you know, if you like great quality products, they have these awesome deck boxes. If you watch my videos, you've seen that before. It's the Archive 800. It can contain deck boxes, but also 800 double sleeve cards. They're ideal for a cube. They have tons of these boxes, different sizes and shapes. They have, that one that's a bit more, maybe if you go to a tournament, you've got the deck boxes, little dice thingies, maybe notepad here. They have all kind of deck boxes, but they have honestly some of the best products on the market. They also have the world famous Katana sleeves. Super great quality. They're up there with couple brands up there, for best sleeves on the market. And Katana is definitely one of, probably the two best sleeve brand you can find for Magic cards. So Ultimate Guard. They also have a website right now. You can do a virtual tour of their offices. I haven't checked it out yet, but that's pretty cool. And I think they're doing giveaways too. If you want, if they're doing giveaways pretty often, honestly. So if you're interested in that, you can give them a follow on Twitter at Ultimate Guard. And this way you'll know when they're doing giveaways and when their new product comes out. All right, Yurion. Yurion means potentially, what's it called? Niv? That's what I've seen recently. Utopia Scroll, etc. All right, no one drop. I'd like to get paired against one of the red decks, see if the matchup's reasonable. I can see it being not that great. Lavadart's pretty good against me. Lightning Bolt's pretty good against me too, to some extent. I could see losing to a good Lavadart draw. That's why I didn't skim. Like, usually mono green big dudes would be favorite against red, but the red decks are just really good in Modern, so I decided to have just all four Kitchen Finks in sideboard for that reason. Well, that was a whoops. I should definitely play that tapped. Or maybe not. Maybe I'll just play another one. Does that make more sense? Plains? Oh yeah, at least I saw it for Lightning Helix, that's right. Man, this is kind of a tough spot. I guess I should play Ronas and then play that. I think the other play you can make is play Revoker Elf and name Teferi Time Raveler. Yeah. I think I'm happy just killing Teferi and recasting Do I want to recast Ronas? Maybe not. What else can I name? Pretty unlikely to have another one, but hits me more on the board and it's more damage next turn. Maybe that, maybe I was a bad play last turn. I kind of like the idea of going for max damage, just playing Ronas into company, attacking for six, pressuring them before things get out of hand with Omnath and Niv. Oh, right, Dev ran in six. Oh, whatever, they play it, they kill one, it dies. Not even that bad for me. Interesting that they killed the Revoker. I mean, they have another Teferi in hand. All right, I'm just gonna say go. Kind of obvious what I have. I don't think they have counter spells or anything in their main deck. Uh-oh, here it comes. Let's see. Bring to light, Lightning Helix, Ren and Six. Could be worse. Let's see. Huh. I think this is pretty straightforward turn. And then play Ronas. I think I'm going to shuffle because I bought him a couple of great henge. My company, if I recall properly, they're probably going to bring to light into some kind of sweeper here. Hopefully they don't have a sweeper that kills Ronas. But they could have Shadow's Verdict. I'm not sure if that's the card they play in this format. It kind of makes sense against all the Lurrus decks and stuff. Mic check, mute check, bottom gross. Interesting. Now they don't have the mana to sweep the board anymore. Maybe they just have the verdict in their hand. That makes sense. Uro, okay. I'm a bit confused. Maybe our plan is just to play Teferi and bounce a human. Other plan is to Lightning Helix the human. But then I have another elf in hand, so they're gonna take a lot. Pull themselves back to 20, that's 5, 8, 15. Oh, dumbass. Another fetch. I guess my guess was they were just hoping I didn't have another 1-1. Yep. Lightning Knight, he likes a human, go back up to 20. No reason to add to the board, I don't think so. Just gonna pump up So I got them in a spot where a verdict is not enough anymore. That's kind of annoying. They didn't have to pay the extra mana for it. I think they had it last turn too and they decided not to cast. Oh, they're just dead. Alright, I'll take it. Is Choke any good against them? Revoker, Ooze, Rex, Sage, Veil. They have a Brub Decays for Veil. Shaper Sanctuary seems good. Oh, let's see. Revoker subs to Fairy and Wren, but you have to guess right. Reclamation Sage kills Utopia Scroll, Bond and Growth, a bit underwhelming. I think Revoker maybe is too low impact. They have too much removal for it. They'll like ignore it when they don't care about it and kill it when they do, kind of a thing. Kitchen Wings could be interesting. Choke might not be the worst either. Just getting one or two lands. Yeah, I'll just try Choke. I mean, if they don't see it coming, it could be good, but they shouldn't really have more than one island in play. Maybe two at some point. Kind of wish I could go back and see what lands they had in play at the end of the last game. I'm not going to do Choke. Finks comes back on the sweeper. Also need to worry about Omnath and Uro. Veil would be mostly for Brub Decays. I'll just do two Kitchen Finks. All right, I have a lot of five power creatures I can draw. Oh, I have the Sprawl draw. Not what I wanted to see. Gone through the gatherer. I played that deck on stream, so I could ask my viewers if I was missing any cards. But if you notice a card that I've definitely missed or some suggestions, feel free to leave that in the comments. This deck's doesn't seem like very close to a tier one deck, but I enjoy my monocolor decks and something a bit different. I've been having fun playing Great Hand and stuff. I don't play a ton of Modern, and I don't have really too many reasons to practice for Moderns right now, so I'd rather go with something just kind of fun rather than a bit different than just jam a bunch of Tier 1 decks necessarily. I'm going to play Ooze, going to remove Uro right away. I added the Force Great Henge because it was the card I felt like I missed the most in the matches I lost yesterday. Slightly different experience today. let's see. 3, 4, 5, 6. All right. Let's play another Ooze right away. I Maybe that's more. Maybe you wait till they play another Uro, and it's a good one to play up the Great Henge, play the Elf first, have more mana out. Yeah, I don't love my Ooze play. I also want to get some damage in. Okay, all right, this game looks like it's kind of over. Did they break? I think they bricked. All right, Ronus. I'm gonna save the elves out of creature to play up the Great Henge, so that actually does something. And then just say go. I don't think I have anything that really deals 2 damage, so it's not like I have to remove my ooze right away. Might as well make it awkward for them if they have a Uro in hand. Brav Decay the ooze. Alright, I'll gain the 1 life. That's not bad for me if that's their first play of the turn. If they don't have a Teferi. Oh, Sisse, yeah, that's a new tech in that deck. It's pretty cool. So it's 2/2/4. A widen 2, and then it gets +1/+1 for each color among other legendary permanents you control. So basically, if you have Niv, it gets +5/+5 because it has all 5 colors. And then for 5 mana, you search for stuff. Search your library for a legendary permanent card that was converted mana cost less than Sisse's power. Put that card onto the battlefield and shuffle your library. So apparently, I think they have some Nissa you can get. If you have no other creatures, I think they play like Ozum Nissa in that deck. Maybe just 1 or 2. And then, you know, obviously once you have Niv in play, you can get more Nivs or you can get Omnath. It's, yeah, it's pretty nasty. It's probably gonna win them the game here. Turn 5 Henge is no match. It's tough though. I mean, I was happy with all the cards I drew. I don't think you want to cut the 1 mana guys in these matchups. The ooze kind of did their work. You got rid of Uro. I was happy to have a Great Henge. I had a 5 drop. It's, you know, could argue that maybe you're supposed to mulligan even more aggressively, but I don't think so. That's fine by me. I'd have been much more worried if it just got themselves an Omnath or something. Just gonna go ahead and chum block, I think. Sorry. It's debating whether to mute the mic or not. All right, I have 1 ooze left, I think. Oh. Let's see if somehow. Oh, it's kind of a somehow. Oh, whoops. Tab the 1/1 instead of the 2/2. Awkward. So I can double block Sisse. Good Could also keep back Rose because it has Death Touch, but I think I need to start attacking them. You just trump Sisseo as a 1-1. Yeah, I played against that deck yesterday, and, or 2 days ago, not yesterday, and it was the first time I think someone ever has that card against me, but it is really cool. Just makes sense. All right, I'll nap. Yikes. They have a fetch land. They do. Oof. Let's see what cool stuff they do with their fetch land. If they have something they can get besides Niv or Omnath, they have another legend. I think you can just get a Teferi too, right? Legendary permanent. You could like just get a Teferi, bounce Steel Leaf Champ, and probably be more than fine. Don't want the Rexage. I mean, it's just too bad if I don't Rexage and it in Rust Sprawl and they're in an 80 card deck, so I don't think so. Tracker, kind of slow. Choke, seems like they just need one island in play. Veil of Summer. Unlikely. I think Revoker, if anything. Revoker might be an interesting one. They're playing that these games kind of weirdly. I feel like they're giving me way more time than they should. All right, what now? My Steel Leaf Champ. I have two Hierarchs. This would be 7 toughness. Could send a Steel Leaf Champ in alone. I think that's what makes the most sense. I'm not sure what their best block is. It could be like Nif plus 1/1 token. That make a ton of sense, actually. We can just get another Nif next turn with Sisse. All right, so I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 mana. Got a pump. We're going to be able to add more to the board. I won't pump. I mean, it's hard to know without knowing what I draw, but I think it's better to have, if ever I draw a company or another elf or something. It's kind of nice to have Finks and Ronas against a deck with sweepers. They play Verdict, it's pretty bad for them. You have to keep Ronas, Finks come back. It has, I think, +1/+1 counter and negates the other counter. I don't know why they didn't attack last turn. Mykthos would be nice here. The rare spot where Mykthos would be pretty sick. What's the deal here? Just attack with a bunch. Seven, 9 mana. All right, maybe attack with all these. Save my ones ones for a Love Struck Beast. Keep 7, 9, 12 mana for Ronas. One play I made the other day, I think I actually won that game, it was a game against Jund. I played a second Great Henge just to gain 2 life. And the 2 life was relevant. I had never made that play before. Pretty tough to get to gain 4. I had a lot of life. And I don't have great ways to race the Niv. I do have that these gain life cards in hand. It's like gain 2 life for free for 1 mana. Pays for itself. They also didn't put Urion in their hand last turn. I'm not sure if that was intentional or not. All right, let's see it. What's going on here? We're gonna pump here. We're gonna pump here. Go pump. Kitchen Finks, I guess. And I wanna pump again or on a pass. I think I should pump again. And I still have a 1/1 to block if I really need to. Get max damage in and yeah. One thing you can tell me in the comments if you like seeing different brews, even if it means I'm not gonna win as much. Not that I always win even with good decks, but you know, do you mind the occasional like 1/4 or 0/5 with terrible deck? Obviously, a lot of different people are want different things. They're gonna have different opinions, but you know, still a little feedback might be useful. Oh, they got the Field of the Dead going on, and Uro back in play. I got them down pretty low though. I have 1 mana up. Wow. Okay. Felt like I should have not won that one, but I'll take it. What a card. What a card Ronas is. Not sure you want a third one, but indestructible death touch. I don't know. It just does it all. I mean, I could see the Revoker as being just bad, you know. I could see not wanting the Revoker and just wanting maybe another Canopy Land or another Ronas, who's number 4. The idea was trying to have a bit of game against Ballista decks and whatnot, but hey, Revoker is a bit underwhelming. Too underwhelming. The other thing, the way I pictured it anyways, I thought it as like, you know, I'm going to have turn 4 Henge and then I want a 2-drop to play of it and Revoker is a nice 2-drop. Oops, I think I wanted to play a fetch land first. Flooded Strand. Oh, makes sense. They're a big fan and they're leading with Flooded Strand. With Lightning Bolt? In my upkeep. Huh. What if I have a 2-mana spell? What now? Alright, I guess I'm glad I didn't play the fetch land now. Might come in handy. And potentially have Mammoth into Henge next turn. I haven't done that yet. I might just have an Archmage Charm though. All right, I'll still go for it. Yeah. All right, I'm going to say at least one of the fetch lands, maybe both. I mean, it could have Mana Leak, I guess. I'll play my land first, it's not costing me much. And the question is, do you play Ooze or not? Or do you want to play Ooze when it has protection from a Lightning Bolt? If I play Ooze, you're going to put something good back on top. They might even just have spells there, honestly. Thing is, if I don't play Ooze, they get to put Charm back on top. Now maybe they put Bolt back on top. No, they still put back Charm. Okay. Honestly, just in case they have Snap or something, I don't think it's worth the one damage. Maybe I should just get the Bolt now. I don't think so. Surprised they didn't put Bolt back on top. Seems like this Ooze could just be a problem now. Do they have Shark Typhoon? I don't think so. Whatever, it's just fodder for my Ooze if Elb dies. So this is a bit tricky. I'm not sure if I want to remove everything. Because of that Cryptic Command bounce my Ooze. Maybe just these two. I would have Magmatic Sinkhole. Huh. That's unfortunate. And one creature short. 5 damage. Alright, well. I wonder why they didn't do their entire graveyard. I guess they figured if I do that, it means I tap out. It means I'm not playing another spell. All right, if I draw a 5-power creature or a land, I can cast a Great Henge. Put my card on the bottom. It's something. I guess they might have Force of Negation. They might just be able to counter every creature I play for the rest of the game. Wouldn't be too surprising, honestly. Slight resolve, it's just a hierarch. It means no harm. Dang. Ruthless. Right, let's start attacking Jace. Can I still win this game realistically? Oof. I love scooping in these spots. I've been scooping a bit more in these spots than I used to. We could have card on the bottom so I don't have to sack my fetch land. I feel like they should be brainstorming and just countering every creature I play rather than doing what they're doing. I guess if your hand is all spells, it makes sense. If they have literally the game locked up, was not even needing to draw another card, might be just faster way to win the game. Put on the bottom again, so I don't have to use my fetch land. All right, choke in, veil in. I think Shaper Sanctuary is probably good enough as well. I think Tracker is probably good enough. I think Ooze might be okay. Revoker is for Jace, but it dies to everything and they have cards like Anger of the Gods after sideboard. I'm gonna board that out. I trim a Great Henge. And sell too many cards. All right, free ooze is good. Yeah, I'll go down to two Great Henge. If I can stick a 5/4, I'm probably in good shape anyways. You can just board out all the Great Henge. Keep it on. Choke is kind of the new Great Henge after sideboard. It's much better and much easier to cast. All right, definitely mixed results on that Forest Great Henge. All right, perfect hands. Might just be a turn two KO here. I'm not sure what I want to play first. I almost want to play Mammoth first. It's just so greedy though. I'm just gonna play the choke. Could have forced some negation. And I kind of missed my window to resolve a big threat on turn two, but I don't even have another land. I guess I have another Mammoth that's a land. I'll play another elf. I mean, they could have an Anger of the Gods, but it would mean they would have to tap their island. It probably mean they have to search for steam vents, so doesn't seem super realistic. I wonder what their plan is for choke out. They have Aether Gust in their deck. You're right, Aether Gust. Totally forgot Musadia's answer. All right, they're stuck on lands. I'm gonna cast it. If they go Aether Gust on choke, untap Anger of the Gods. I guess it means I get to recast choke. Okay, so it's not even that bad. That's 12. All right. All right, the Great Henge does not get better on the draw. The think this is still good. All right, good enough. No choke, but no choke, no veil. But a solid curve. I think four toughness creatures are just pretty good against them. They're bold decks. At least my hand doesn't really miss a beat. And now I kind of have to hope their hand misses a beat. It's probably a matchup that's varies, like how many ether gusts. If they have like two ether gusts, probably okay. If they have like four ether gusts, probably it's pretty rough. Didn't expect that to resolve. Unless they're just messing with me and they just ether gusted end of turn instead of when it's on the stack. All right, well, that's them missing a beat already. Unless they have different plans for the Steel Leaf champ. Not much though, Flame Slash. All right, my spell is probably getting countered. Would I rather get, maybe get a Great Henge countered now? I could just have Force of Negation. Oh, it just resolves. What do they have? Oh. I'll play that as a land. Weird. I guess they drew the lightning bolt on a bunch of cryptics and Snapcaster Mage. Let's see. Kind of want to use the mana of the henge right now before they change their mind. I guess if they had some way to bounce it, they would have done it already. Played that matchup once last night with this deck, and I did get the match 2-0. Not sure what bait's supposed to be here. I think I just want to play my Ronas first. I think I'd rather get my Ronas countered by Cryptic Command than my Steel Leaf Chim countered by Cryptic Command is basically what it is. I'm going to play that because it can bold the mammoth with the triggers on the stack. I wonder if they have some crazy. I need to have like hibernation. Become random. No, there's no way to have hibernation over more ether gusts. No, they just. Life of a control player. Sometimes you just got to keep sketchy hands. Where you don't have a perfect curve. Seems like maybe they should have mulliganed. No bull turn one, no Reman, no charm, no gust. Maybe they already mulliganed. No, they kept seven. These blue decks still mulligan super well, but. See. They could just cryptic lock me. Do I have something to get rid of the cryptic lock? I have choke. Maybe they have the cryptic lock. Maybe I'll lose this game. If they have like two cryptic commands and a bunch of force of negations. I guess I get to draw a lot of cards. Eventually I draw choke plus veil. Tap, return target permanent, tap all creature. Okay. I'm not sure why you would bounce that rather than draw a card. I guess you have force of... I probably have force of negation in hand. I think I'm happy. Am I happy? I'll be efficient. Oh wait, no, that's terrible. Oh no, the great hand's gonna get countered, right? We've already established that. Hey, no, it's not gonna count. I mean, why else would you bounce it if you're not gonna counter it with a force here? I'll play it now while it makes them use two cards. No, never mind. I totally level myself. Cost myself a card. All right, got there. Felt pretty easy last night. This match felt definitely way closer. And, you know, it's like, oh, this match is pretty good. I have a bunch of four toughness creatures, but I could easily see, like, them curving out, you know, Reman, Counter, Cryptic Command, and then, you know, a bunch of Mystic Sanctuaries in a row, and I never get out of the ground, especially if I'm on the draw. Let's see if we can complete the rally from 0-2 to 3-2. I did win more matches than or more games than I lost. I'm 6-5 in games. Gonna refill the water glass. Stay hydrated. Especially when you're talking for 2 hours straight. Oh, my token. Automatic is starting real quick. I didn't get super excited about much, but I've been pretty excited about the token. So yeah, that's the token you get if you ever you place an order and you use the code YellowHat, you get a free token, a free Gabriel Nassif token and with your order. And Jessica just made such an incredible job. It has a cruel ultimatum, reflecting pool, the YellowHat. I love it. So code YellowHat. I know there's a bunch of other content creator at ChannelFireball that have their own code or their own token. So, you know, if you have someone else you want to support or another favorite content creator, you know, make sure you use one of the codes. Yeah, costs you nothing. We get all commission and you get that free token. Lurrus. All right, let's see if I can get my revenge against Lurrus. Oh, it's the mill deck. Well, at least I have my one guy's blessing in the sideboard. And I might be able to just kill him faster. Also, ooze might be good against him. I was going to say I need fetch land, but I don't know about fetch land plus against Archive Trap. So yeah, the tech, whenever mill gets popular, you just throw Guy's Blessing or Kozlak in your sideboard, and it doesn't win you the match, but it does help a lot. You know, they can surgical it when you mill it, but sometimes the one mill is good enough, is just what you need. Let's see, don't want to play 1-1 into a Lobstruck Beast. We don't want to get an ooze out there. Definitely Heart's Desire. Oh, you know what? I should have played Mama Stabbed. Wow. That was a huge mistake. I was like not paying attention at all. Thanks. Just like in standard, monogreen against a bunch of crabs. Who can win faster? Right, I drew the land. Do I still want to play Lovestruck Beast? I want to play the Mammoth at this point. I mean, I'm gonna be able to kill them nearly fast enough. But yeah, I was saying the one shuffle effect usually is enough to like buy you enough time to, win the game. Does that one do already? I have the four types. Think I have to play that even that Field of Ruin. Do you have to play the ooze? That's bad news. Don't think I can win. I'll do that. I guess I need to sack it now before they get a window to get it. Yeah, that was me. I wasn't just not supposed to play it at all. I think I made a mistake. Oh. I'm so dumb. I like yielded to that, so I didn't get to. Oh my God. All right, that was bad. I'm just supposed to board out my non-basics against their Field of Ruin. Definitely want to get rid of their Rune Crab. I mean, I don't even know what I'm supposed to There's no way I can win, right? Right. Who won the die roll? They did, right? Yeah. Right, I want choke or not. Damn. I definitely want Rex Age. I definitely want Gaia's Blessing. Revoker doesn't name lands. I think Veil is not what I want either. Definitely don't want Henge. Maybe one. Definitely want all the elves. Think Revoker does literally nothing. I guess I'll do the ooze. I guess I'll do the chokes and veils. Could do Shaper Sanctuary too, but I don't know if I need to draw more cards. Maybe Shaper's Sanctuary is just better than the Great Henge. Maybe I want Veil over something. Does Veil protect you from crab meals? It's probably each open, right? I don't know, Veil might just be good enough. But there's nothing else I really wanna... I'll do one Veil. I was actually debating putting a second Gaia's Blessing type effect in my sideboard. It might be worth it if Mill becomes really popular and your other cards, some of your other sideboard cards are just pretty underwhelming. I've talked about it before, but you get just such value out of these anti-mill sideboard cards just because you don't need to draw them. You're gonna mill them at some point, and that's kind of just it, you know? It's like having a sideboard card that you always draw and that you always get to use for free, which is just totally absurd. The same reason why the Scape cards are really good against Rogue in a format like Standard. All right, I guess I'm trying not to use my fetch lands. Oh, it's gonna be, yeah. Gonna be easy. And you do get to put 8 crabs now. This target player. So I could see Veil saving you from I feel like as long as I don't draw my Gaia's Blessing, I should be mostly okay this game. Because that's a good start. It's interesting. Collected Company or Lovestruck Beast, Heart's Desire. I'll just do Company. More fun, more damage. Yeah. All right, they mailed the Gaia's Blessing. That was great. And they didn't have Surgical. So the game feels almost unlosable at this point when you get a good blessing and good start. Let's see. I'll be really impressed if they can beat it. It's also even worse when it's out of an aggro deck because you don't really want to have to keep in Surgical Extraction against the aggro deck. He just ran us. I feel like I can maybe get own if I play Ronos though. If I had one more land in hand, then Ronos would be good because I can like have to deal with that creature and I can pump the human. But all right, good enough. Yeah, it really does feel like kind of a thing of, I'm gonna bring in a second. It's so hard to keep one mana up though at all times. I guess I'm not gonna bring in the Veil. Yeah, what was I saying? Yeah. I feel like as long as I don't naturally draw my Gaia's Blessing, I'm in pretty decent shape. Maybe Forus is nonsense and way too slow. I'll do the second Veil. Slow hand, but I do have company and a playable hand, and I don't have Guy's Blessing. I guess I can't have Guy's Blessing in my opening hand if I'm all in. I think this is good enough. I can also just draw a one drop. All right, I'm just going to fetch now before they potentially draw an Archive Trap. Sounds pretty slow. Definitely feels kind of alling on me having Gaia's Blessing in my deck, because I am not going to kill them fast. We also have Crypt Incursion. I think it like removes creatures, so that would be tech, like mail me a bunch, Crypt Incursion, a lot of creatures, and then when I finally shuffle, I just have all lands left. Okay, they brought in Solgad Lantern. That's their anti-blessing tech. Still get to reshuffle. Oh yeah, that's really good against, actually, that's single-handedly counters Blessing, right? Thanks. So now I'm in a spot where if I don't, I don't know why I attacked in Sorb, if my Blessing's not in the like top few cards of my deck, I'll lose because they get to exile the graveyard. I do have Rexage to push. All right, I'll veil that. All right. Choke. That's for one blue. They're stuck on lands. Could be good. Or I could just try and kill them. Man, I have no idea. Love Struck Beast or Choke. You don't even really cast spells to kill me. I guess I'll just put a Love Struck Beast. Do I play it safe? I think my Rexage would be nice. Oh, wow. Put the, each card put... How does it work? Click each card to put it on the bottom of your library or any... I don't know how it works when you... what's the order to have the blessing closest to the top? I actually have no idea. That's bad news, though. Well, I guess I get to play another company next turn. What would make more sense? I think clicking the veil first would make more sense. But I could be wrong. And they're starting to chomp. That's kind of a weird play. I mean, they're worried about Steel Leaf Cham, but... I guess Choke might have been a good play after all. Should I cut my losses? I think I'll go Company again so that my Blessing's not in the bottom of my deck. Also, try to hit that Rex Sage. Wait, they didn't sack it? Why would you not want to exile my graveyard? This way I have less stuff to reshuffle back in. Oh, wait. Whoa. I'm done. I have mana left. Oof. Hope that doesn't cost me the game. Oh, okay. Makes more sense. Well. All right, I think I get to play Choke next turn and add a bit to the board. Yeah, not playing that Elf. It could be game losing, I doubt it, but you never know. Play that, just in case I have a push for my 1-1. Attack with everyone. So my blessing's like ace from the top or something. Not sure I have a way to... Actually, I do have a way to manipulate my library. I have Waterlogged Grove. Kind of trying to make sure I don't draw the blessing. I'm not sure if that actually helps me not drawing the blessing. It might. If I do it in response to a mill trigger to make sure they mill the blessing and I don't draw it. All right, got there. Very close, and game one feels really bad, so maybe you won the second one. But yeah, that was the deck I was showing you earlier, the 8 discard spell. When I played the late game, I only had 6 discard spells, but I think you won all 8. I think this is a bit worse than the Uriah deck. People like to hit on the Uriah, but at least it gives you some nutty draws, and it lets you... play Emery and stuff because you need more artifacts, but let's take a quick look at modern Stompy over here. All right, Forest Grid Henge was definitely not great for me. So maybe you just want some other creatures. Didn't get to play against Shred, so we don't really know if the lands are going to hurt us, but I think they were pretty good. And feels like in almost every matchup, you're happy to have them. So, yeah. I think I would consider maybe a second Gaia's Blessing in the sideboard. I would almost definitely consider a third Choke. Tracker, Ooze, kind of whatever. Sodek did win one of the recent challenges was Dredge. So Dredge might be making a small comeback. I'm not sure there's any other creatures you really, really want to play, honestly, that are super exciting to play in this deck. I don't think you want the third Rowanus. Yeah, not too sure. Some kind of fight cards, but there's no great fight cards. Yeah, and maybe go with the Haymakers. Maybe like the cards I'm not super excited about. I could see second Shaper, second Blessing for a Choke for sure instead of some of these creatures. But yeah, hope you enjoyed the slight change of pace, the aggro deck. Still a couple hours videos, me talking about playing against a bunch of slow decks and me talking about the deck and stuff. But yeah, as usual, make sure you sub to the YouTube channel if you haven't done so yet. And if you like the content, leave a message, leave a like. If you want to support the content, you can check out channelfireball.com. You can use code YellowHead. They have everything you need magic-wise. They also have CFB Pro, which is premium content and really worth it. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you next time.